Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here at the Coliseum Gym in Dublin with me. I've got Tommy McCarthy. Tommy, I've just seen you do a good couple of rounds sparring there against Steve Collins Jr. I mean, your last fight as well, you won the WBC International.
Yeah.
I mean, how's camp going? How are you feeling?
Everything's went brilliant since I came down and joined the team. So, after that was a big win for me out in Italy. Mm-hmm. And it's really just put me right where I wanted to be. Like before, it was unranked, and then it was coming off. Well, I'd get beat earlier in the year by React 4. So, a couple of easy fights to get back into it. Well, not easy fights, just a couple of fights. Got two wins, and then that opportunity came around. Linked up with Pete, we went over and won it. So, I went from in 2019, in March, it was rock bottom, and then by October, it was up in the world rankings. You know what I mean? So, I've put myself in the conversation for a world title, because you have to be top 15 with a WBC. So I'm 13 now, number 2 in Britain in Boxrec behind Acoli, and I'm just managing for the European as well now. So I'm right where I wanted to be. So everything's just went perfect.
Is that just a testament to just hard work? Even though you've been to the rock bottom against React,
yeah.
I mean, is that just testament to obviously you, Pete, and everybody else, and what hard work pays off?
Definitely the hard work and, you know, self belief, because after the Raghpur fight, I said to myself, my cousins came up and watched, and I said to them, I was like, lads, that's it, I'm packing it in them. If I can't, because see that Raghpur fight, I came at late notice, so I didn't rate him before. I was like, I'll beat him, no problem. So I didn't have any respect for him going in that fight. It took it 2 weeks. That's how, you know, arrogant I was, kind of. So I was like, it went, obviously went wrong. So I was going to pack it in, and my cousin said to me, he was like, I had to give him a shout out, Tim. He says, look, listen, bruv, this is a new beginning, bruv. You're going to do big things.
He's not Irish.
Nah, he's from London. He's from London. He was like, bruv, this is a new beginning, bruv. Trust me, this is the new birth and big things coming for you. And I was like, Redwood, he's my cousin who I've always looked up to. Mm-hmm. Like, he's a year older than me, so I've always took anything he said, no, like really took heed to what he said. So I was like, maybe he's right. And then I got home and said to my wife, I was like, I don't know if I'm cut out for this boxing game. She says, look, I know how good you are. You just need to realize how good you are. If I thought you were getting hurt and you weren't good enough, I'd be the first one to tell you to retire because I love you, but you just need to get back to work. So, you know, I had to believe in myself and believe that I can do it, and then make the adjustments with my team. So I got in touch with Pete, and it's coming out of my comfort zone. Mm-hmm. I live in Belfast, I come down and train in Dublin, but it's all paid off in the end. So like you say, testament to hard work, dedication and belief, because everybody else rounds, you can't listen to what people saying. Yeah. They're all going, forget about McCarthy, he's shit, hype job, all that. Just had to block it out, get the blinkers on, and now I'm back where I wanted to be.
Do you want to go back to that fight in Italy? I mean, you were coming up against, you were in his backyard. What's it, Fuse, what's his name again?
Fabio Turri.
That's it. I know, I'm glad you said it. You went into his backyard, he was an undefeated fighter. He had a high KO, I think it was 17 wins, 13 KOs.
Yeah.
I mean, you were the underdog going in.
Yeah.
When the referee, or the judges' scorecards were read out, I mean, how did you feel at that moment in time? But it was a split decision as well.
Yeah, see, during the fight, I actually felt like I was winning. No, I felt in control the whole time. So at the end, I was like, yep, I've definitely won. And then when they said split decision, and as well with the WBC, every four rounds, they call it what the scores are. So forget what it was after eight, but I needed to win three of the last four, and I felt like I'd done it. So I was like, yes, definitely won. And when they called split decision, my heart sank. I was like, no way. And
because especially being in Italy,
yeah,
as well,
Italy's notorious for like people not getting decisions. So when the judge called it the score, I looked at Pete, and Pete put his hand up. So that's me, yes. And then they called me out. It was like a big relief, because it's been a long time coming for me to pick up my first title. And the magnitude of the win and the opponent, like, he was look. I was brought in to get beat as a stepping stone for him to move on for the fight for the WBC title. And in Italy, he's like the face of Matchroom Italy. He's the poster boy for it. So I think the majority of Italians thought that was for the world title. They all thought Fabio was world champion. And even after I won, people back home text me, what's it like to be world champion? And everyone just because the size of the fight, it was top of the bill and live on Sky and his own. So it just felt great. It was like literally living the dream. To a certain degree, top of the bill fighting everyone scared. The only thing that didn't make it the dream was it wasn't for the world title, but it was just a big relief getting it, and finally I'm where I want to be.
Exactly. Well, everything's stages, everything that you said, like you rock bottom, 2 years you fight to come back, 1 year WBC international title, you're now mandatory for the European title.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know who the champion is, forgive me. You know.
Well, Akoli's the champion, but...
Oh, yes, but is he not going to vacate the world title show?
So, that's what we're waiting to see who I'm going to fight for. So, I'm just training. Because, you know, being in Ireland, you don't get the full notice. So, you probably get about 4 weeks, 5 weeks to want to be on this show. So, I've just got in my mind that I'm going to be fighting in March. And I'm just training along with... like the Tyrones and Luke's away fighting for the world hit well on Thursday, so I'm just in camp now ready for the call.
But you're thinking it's not going to be Akoli, because Akoli,
no, it's not going to be Akoli, he's fighting for
the world
hit
title, so yeah.
So, but it could be anyone, so I just want to stay ready for anyone.
What's that European belt for you, mean for you then? I mean, are you just going to be one of them guys with just belts around your waist, up your arms?
See, to be honest, you know, when I started boxing at 12, my goal was just to be a world champion. There's no interest in European or British or anything else. I just want to be world champion. So I look at the European title as a stepping stone towards a world title.
Talk to me about, I want to go visit the Vyacpo fight as well. I mean, you said it yourself, you only had 2 weeks notice, you were arrogant going into the fight, sort of stuff. If that ever happened, the rematch ever happened again, do you think, obviously, with a full camp, with Pete, taking it a little bit more serious in your record, do you think maybe you could beat somebody like Vyacpo, who's obviously...
He's a British champion, and you know, I have big respect for Richard, and he's proven that he is, like, he's the real deal. Before, you know, I was just like, I didn't take him serious. I thought this was an easy win for me. So I got in there, and you know, it wasn't an easy win. And since then, he's went on, he's beat all good
Chris
Billen Smith, Jack Massey. He beat Sam Haid before me, so he's, you know, he's somebody who steps up to the plate every time. So if I was to fight him again, definitely we'd be taking it serious, and my mind would be right. And with Pete now, the guy trusts Pete 100%. He will get me the victory against anyone.
But that's about two more questions about a couple of world title fights coming up. Luke Keeler is a gym mate, I'll leave that to last.
Yeah.
Akoli, how do you think he'll fare in his effort? I don't think it's been announced yet, but it's more highly likely it's going to happen. So,
you know, Akoli is still, he has an ugly stare, like he always gets chipped, but he's effective. And I say it's better to win ugly than lose pretty, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I think they'll probably win it. So, you know, good luck to him. But I do, he just has that style, especially for a cruiserweight, he's so big and gangly. So nobody's been really able to figure out the puzzle.
Luke Keeler then, I mean, you're in camp with him. I mean, he's out in Miami's fighting Thursday night against Demetrius Andrade. I mean, again, another testament to hard work and dedication. Luke's exactly the same thing, coming off a loss, one of these hard, tough fights. How do you think he'll fare on Thursday?
Yeah, I think, I have belief in Luke. You know, Luke is one of the primary reasons why I came here, because when I went and I watched him in the field at him on Mixed Show, I thought he was going to get beat by Aris, because Luis Aris and me are the same age, so I know him from the amateurs, and I know he had good pedigree. Me and him went to the Worlds, both got bronze medals, he fought for a world title. I was like, this is a big step up for Luke. See, so yeah, they're watching the first round, it's me, Luke's unreal. And then he went on to win. So I tweeted him and it says, how are you the most improved boxer in Ireland? And he just wrote back, Pete Taylor. So I text Pete straight away.
Oh wow.
And people say, yeah, it'll work with me. So Luke is in the same position he's been for the last three fights. Underdog, nobody expecting anything off him. and he just show up and do the business. So I'm expecting him to show up and do it again here. And he's just, as you say, it's hard work. And he was at Rock Bottom when he fought, I forget the guy's name, from England. And he got stopped and he's built himself right back up to here. Even win, lose, or draw, he's at the world level, so he'll come again. But I'm expecting him to win, and he gets a world title, it'll just give a lift to the whole camp. Like, it's been a mad lift, him, no, just like the buzz in the camp, no, him preparing. So he brings it home to be unreal.
Tommy titles in this gym now, man. It'd be loads of them. You, your title, his title,
exactly. It'd be great. So, champion's gym, and you know, we have to give all credit to Pete. Pete is just like, I would say, like a boxing geek. Like, he just knows boxing, studies it every single day. He knows how to get the best out of all the fighters, and I'm proof that, you know, for years people going about me, like, he's, we know he can do it, but why hasn't he done it? First fight with him, bang, got the title. Luke was like a domestic level fighter, and now he's world levels. The Tyrones have joined here. They're absolutely flying. They've got the golden contract coming up. Big Stevie Collins are. Stevie, the improvements he's made is unreal. So, Pete is the man.
Definitely, I won't keep much longer, Tommy. Yes, back, no problem. To Belfast. Yep. I might see you in Belfast starting a bit.
I'm going to be at the show anyway. Because, you know, my two teammates are fighting, Davey and Gary. And then my mate, Sean McCombs, one of my best mates. Oh, yeah, so, yeah. I'll be down supporting him.
So I'll see you then.
I'll see you, yeah. Yes.
Definitely. Thanks, Tommy, for doing this. Bye from TV, and catch up with you soon.
Good luck.
Good man.
Gold Star Promotions is proud to present Floyd Money Mayweather. The man himself is coming to the UK for his UK tour, February and March 2020. For all info and tickets, Gold Star Promotions, the host of UK.